and welcome to all my YouTube family members. So yeah, today's vlog is about veneration of Our Lady at my house. So to begin with, I started decorating the altar, and as usual the lights were entangled, so then I started decorating the wall, and this is how I did it. And I didn't use any tapes, nothing, just a string, and that's it. So then this is a curtain that I put over it to get that extra effect. So then here I put on the flowers. I was checking which looks good, pink and purple or mixture of both, or whether should only I use one. But then I remembered that the color of here is magenta pink, so then I said no, I will use only pink color, and voila, the lights also brightened up the wall. And then I started to drape the table on which Mother Mary's statue would be kept on this table. And then I was giving the finishing touches here and there, just small pins and all. Oh my god, those are really a big headache to, you know, pin it up and then it for it to remain. But then it remained well. And then here I put the photos of Mother Mary and Jesus back, and there, yeah, this is the final look of my table that which I decorated to keep Mother Mary's statue. So then this is the next day. I went to pick up some nice garland, and then yeah, this is I started cooking with the sign of the cross. That is what always my mom and dad have told me, like, you know, take the name of God and start your cooking. So then I kept the grams for boiling, and then this is chicken. This chicken would be used for shredding, because I'll be making chicken Caesar roll and boiled grams, that is to distribute after the veneration of Our Lady. In my house, it is always that we try to make some or the other eatable that is to be distributed in our house. Because see, when it is our birthdays or wedding anniversaries, we be so excited that we start cooking for more than 100 people. Then why not during Our Lady? So here, then I chopped the cabbage. Then it was a turn of chopping iceberg lettuce, and simultaneously my grams also were getting boiled, so I added in the salt and it was ready. And really, it was really very hot that day. And here, then I started packing the grams, and my grams also I packed them in butter paper bags, because, you know, no usage of plastic, save the earth. So yeah, so then I started packing them in this butter paper bags, and then yeah, I started mixing the chicken Caesar salad that was to be stuffed inside the bread. And here, this is Preeti. Well, she is very camera conscious, she was trying to hide. And then this is my Pulton member, Vienna. So they came in to help for me while packing. Yeah, the grams were packed, and then your chicken Caesar rolls also were ready, and then we started packing them. And simultaneously my biryani rice also was getting ready for my near and dear close ones who were there to help me, so then for dinner party. And then this is after the packing of the eatables. And then yeah, this is Blanca. We were ready to, and yeah, this is Vienna, and this is Strasel. So we were ready to go and collect Mother Mary from my neighbor's house. And here, this is Genevieve. So she was bidding adieu by saying the prayers. And then here, I was very anxious that when Mother Mary's statue will be in my hand. And finally, here, me holding Mother Mary. And wow, that feeling is really awesome. So yeah, with a very happy and a joyful heart, I was heading back home.
In front.
And to the viewers who are not aware about my family, well, my family resides abroad, and this is my godmother. She was welcoming Mother Mary in the house.
Ave Maria, Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ore mai disalamce, sove suja purgace. Ore mai disalamce, sove suja purgace.
Enjoy the lovely voice of all my Kolmororkas singing the hymns. And here, this is a video I took after all the devotees went, after distributing the eatables and everything. And if you all have noticed, here these are the flowers which I have used, which I had purchased from the Navili Fair. So every year after Our Lady, we have a family get-together dinner. And then yeah, I had cooked some chicken gravy, some veg gravy, and this is my biryani rice. Sorry, it got over little as I was shooting. And this is fruit custard. Now this is the next day when I had to bid adieu to Mama Mary so that she goes to the neighbor's house and blesses their house. Sadly, but with a very happy and joyful heart, I was kissing Mother Mary's frame, and I was really feeling melancholy. And on a higher note, I prayed for all my YT family. I prayed for everyone who I know. And I am, maybe I'm too small to say this, but I know that Mother Mary is guarding us and protecting us, all of us. And here, my neighbor came to take Mother Mary to his house. So that's it. This is how I celebrated the veneration of Mother Mary in my house. I hope you all loved it. And if you all loved it, do like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.